Hello, how are you today? Today we're going to look at Exodus chapter 18. Now Jethro, the priest of Midian, and father-in-law of Moses, heard of everything God had done for Moses and for his people Israel, and how the Lord had brought Israel out of Egypt. After Moses has sent away his wife Zipporah, his father-in-law Jethro received her and her two sons. One son was named Gershom, for Moses said, "I have become an alien in a foreign land." And the other was named Eleazar, for he said, "My father's God was my helper. He saved me from the sword of Pharaoh." Jethro, Moses' father-in-law, together with Moses' sons and wife, came to him in the deserts, where he was camped near the mountain of God. Jethro had sent word to him, "I, your father-in-law Jethro, am coming to you with your wife and her two sons." So Moses went out to meet his father-in-law and bowed down and kissed him. They greeted each other and then went into the tents. Moses told his father-in-law about everything the Lord had done to Pharaoh and the Egyptians for Israel's sake, and about all the hardships they had met along the way, and how the Lord had saved them. Jethro was delighted to hear about all the good things the Lord had done for Israel in rescuing them from the hand of the Egyptians. He said, "Praise be to the Lord, who rescued you from the hand of the Egyptians and of Pharaoh, and who rescued the people from the hand of the Egyptians. Now I know that the Lord is greater than all the other gods, and for he did this to those who had treated Israel arrogantly." Then Jethro, Moses' father-in-law, brought a burnt offering and other sacrifices to God. And Aaron came with all the elders of Israel to eat bread with Moses' father-in-law in the presence of God. The next day Moses took his seat to serve as judge for the people, and they stood around him from morning till evening. When his father-in-law saw all that Moses was doing for the people, he said, "What is this you are doing for the people? Why do you alone sit as judge, while all these people stand around you from morning till evening?" Moses answered him, "Because the people come to me to seek God's will. Whenever they have a dispute, it is brought to me, and I decide between the parties and inform them of God's decrees and laws." Moses' father-in-law replied, "What you are doing is not good. You and these people who come to you will only wear yourselves out. The work is too heavy for you. You cannot handle it alone. Listen now to me and I will give you some advice. And may God be with you. You must be the people's representative before God and bring their disputes to him. Teach them the decrees and laws and show them the way to live and the duties they are to perform. But select capable men from all the people, men who fear God, trustworthy men who hate dishonest gain, and appoint them as officials over thousands, hundreds, fifties, and tens. Have them serve as judges for the people at all times, but have them bring every difficult case to you. The simple cases they can decide themselves. That will make your load lighter, because they will share it with you. If you do this and God so commands, you will be able to stand the strain, and all these people will go home satisfied." Moses listened to his father-in-law and did everything he said. He chose capable men from all Israel and made them leaders of the people, officials over thousands, hundreds, fifties, and tens. They served as judges for the people at all times, the difficult cases they brought to Moses, but the simple ones they decided for themselves. But Moses sent his father-in-law on his way, and Jethro returned to his own country. Well, there we are. There we have another great reading. Jethro, Moses' father-in-law, meets up with Moses. He wants to know what he's been up to, what's been happening. And then Jethro recognizes Moses' God, the one true God that we believe in, and worships him and eats bread. And they all have this wonderful celebratory meeting together. But you know, there's a couple of things in here that really, really speak to me. The first part is Jethro says to Moses, "Why are you doing all these things?" And then he says to him, "If you do all these things, the workload will be too heavy and you cannot handle it alone. And you'll just wear yourself out." How many Christian workers and Christian leaders, Christian pastors, try to do everything for themselves, and they try to hold the whole church together, whether it's thousands, whether it's hundreds, whether it's fifties, or whether it's tens. And then Jethro identifies the people then around Moses, and he says, "Well, why are these people standing here where you're doing all of these things?" So then he starts to deputize, he starts to spread the load amongst the others. And I think that's a lesson that we can really learn today from this particular passage. Don't take everyone's troubles and burdens and worries on yourself. If you're leading a house group, a children's group, whether you're leading a church, a small church, or a large church, you need to get others around you and encourage them, work with them, and grow them as well, so that they can effectively do God's work in a way that you can't do because you're only one person. This particular passage has really spoken to me as well. So I just thank God for Exodus chapter 18. And I thank him because he cares about us. He created us and he loves us. He didn't create us to just wear us out and make us tired. But anyway, I hope you've got something from this passage in the way that I have. God bless you, have a great day, and I'll speak to you again tomorrow.